Hello.
Hi.
Hi.
This, so this is the Tau Polyphemona Sax Quartet.
Which is five.
Which is five people. Just squint and turn your head off. We're a quartet on some pieces. He plays for the cajon on a couple things. So. We're right sometimes. I really don't know how to introduce yourselves, but most of you know me, but I, alumni here 4 years ago.
Woo!
Kingsley. Right. Okay.
Just go down the line.
Okay, so yeah, Kingsley. Great.
What's your major? The 3 points.
The 3 points, okay. At college, I studied aerospace engineering. I'm a fourth year, and yeah, I'm playing soprano also.
What are you playing?
I play in wind ensemble. I played in jazz, but I'm not going to answer that. Sax choir, sax quartet, and I'm the director of the pet band on campus. And I'm at a couple of off-campus music groups.
And he tries to pass his classes.
I'm Teresa. I'm a fourth year. I am a music industry studies major, so more on the business side of music, or you can do the tech side. It goes both ways. I am a fourth year. I don't know if I said that yet. Play barry sax. I also play a little bit of alto and flute. And I am in jazz band, solo ensemble. I've been in wind ensemble, sax choir, sax quartet, and have been president for a couple music clubs.
I'm Nick. I'm a third year music education major. I play the barry sax. I play tenor, but not enough tenor to be recognized by my teacher. I've been in the concert band, the wind ensemble, solo ensemble, and I'm playing in a couple of off-campus groups with Kingsley and others.
Hi, my name's Albert. I'm a third year mechanical engineering student. I play in the wind ensemble, I played in the concert band, sax choir, and sax quartet. What else? Am I missing anything? Nope, that's about it.
Okay, and I'm the shared teacher, and my name is Lori Huff. I've been at Cal Poly for 30 years, soon to retire. They say not till they're done, though. That they're telling me that, so. I play usually alto and soprano. But for the last 2 years or 3 years, we haven't had a tenor that's good enough to sit with the group of tenors. Actually, Nick is a good tenor player. But when he first started, he wasn't. And the next year, the wind ensemble needed a barry player, and they said, why don't you try Nick on barry? And it was like a natural thing for us. So we don't let them switch back very often. So that's the deal with that. But the reason there's five of us is a lot of times when we do things, we do jazz numbers. Teresa would play the barry parts. Our classical numbers, Nick would play barry. And then we found out he could play cajon. And one of the things we're doing this quarter is we're doing a performance of all pentatonic music. So you need somebody that either beatboxes or plays cajon. So he is our percussionist right now, venue. So that's why there's five of them. And we do have one piece for quintet.
So
you want to announce your first piece?
The first piece we're going to do is Simple Gifts by Lenny Niehaus, which we did in Paris last year. So I just figured it would be appropriate to do that.
Thank you.
We do this kind of informally, so if you have a question you want to ask anybody up here, in between numbers, just raise your hand and ask away. This is your chance to get knowledge about how universities work, how these guys feel about playing in groups while being in other majors, the whole bit. So, feel free.
Okay, so the next piece is another Lenny Hughes piece.
Called again?
A cajon. C-A-J-O-N.
And does it like make different sounds or is it just a box?
It's a box. It's a box. There's a snare. There's a snare inside. The snares can differ in like size and whatever.
Is it like hollow in different places?
Yeah.
Oh, there's a hole.
It's a box. There's a hole in the back. It's hollow like a box. There's a snare at the top right here. Of course, the top for like a snare hit. And then it's
That makes sense. Okay, thank you.
Moving on. This is our only actual quintet. It's an arrangement I found online. Looking for something else that's arranged themselves. There's a lot of stuff that you're going to hear today, which is not purchased. It's found off of MuseScore, which is the easiest way to find modern contemporary music that people want to listen to. So that's the reason for that. But it don't mean a thing.
Thank you.
All right, so besides getting our music going, we do buy some. Or actually, I buy some, I guess. And one of the places that we get a lot of our music from is a website that's attached to the National Saxophone Choir. And it's Saxtet Publications. And we originally went on the site to look for things for octets and choirs. And while I was there, I just bought some quartet stuff. So we basically have this piece for 4, 5, 8, and 10, or 12 people. And this is entitled Witch Hunt. And I think, Kingsley, you're the one that went, I like this piece.
Sounds good. Not easy, but...
Play notes so fast.
There's kids. Anyone leaving for an AP?
Well, there it is.
They all left. Okay. I'm sorry for the interruption.
They'll all tell you that practice helps. They'll also tell you that learning all their scales helps a whole bunch. And doing arpeggios, thirds, you name it. also helps you when you're sight reading to fake better.
Very impressive.
At what age did all of you guys start playing saxophone originally?
I started saxophone in fourth grade. That's 10, 8, 9, I don't know.
I started on flute in fifth grade and changed to barry sax in eighth grade.
I started playing sax in seventh grade.
I started on flute in fifth grade and went to sax in eighth grade also.
Fifth grade.
Anybody else? Yeah, why don't you two? That would be a good idea. Does to look for two other members. And they found Avi, which he's, I think he was like 24 when they got him. And he is their bass, so to speak. But he also sings quite well and does stuff really high too. And then they went on there and they found this cello player that was beatboxing at the same time playing cello. And that's when they gathered Kevin into the mix. And he is their beatboxer, but since then he's been taking vocal lessons, and sometimes they're just a total a cappella quintet with voices instead of the bass and beatbox version. So if you haven't seen them on YouTube, you need to. The one young man, Mitch, he sings higher than most girls I know. His falsetto is probably the purest thing you've ever heard. And in that respect, Avi sings lower than anybody I've ever heard. He can rattle the ground. So they're just, for as young as they are, you know, think about yourselves. You know, you're 17, you've got $1 million now. Mm. Needless to say, Mitch did finish high school. He was smart. The other two never went back to, I think one was at Yale and one was at somewhere, Harvard or something. They just left, much to their parents' dismay, and never went back, so. But I think they'll make more money than they'll ever make. And record companies right now are trying to buy their contract from Sony, so. So you want to announce this one?
We're doing one of the more recent ones they're doing. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Arranged by some name I cannot pronounce, but.
Originally arranged for string quintet or string quartet, so it puts us up, some of us up pretty high.
Thank you.
started the whole pentatonic thing. Kingsley brought in this arrangement for a sax quartet. So he found out music. We went, oh, this is kind of cool. I think he was amazed that I knew who they were, though, too.
I was highly.
So. The other thing that's cool about the box, it carries a lot of stuff. Every once in a while, we can say, why is the box not loud enough? It's because he's got a sweater. Okay? So, medley of death.
Thank you.
I've seen the video of that, and it sounds like just like it. How do you make it to sound like just like it? Like, do you get, like, do you rearrange? Or, like, how do you, where do you...
The person that arranged that one, it's an amazing thing, because if you looked at our parts, the rhythms are really funky in that. And the person that actually arranged it and took it right off of there should be actually arranging for money. Because they took it pretty much right off the video. But there's the one thing that's bad about doing arrangements of certain vocal tunes and pop tunes is, especially with pentatonics, is they do some very tricky rhythms. And so there's a lot of things that we don't normally see when we play that way. I killed myself one quarter. I used to direct the MIDI band, and I decided, wow, it'd be really cool to do video game music. And they wanted to kill me after the second one. But we had some good arrangers, and we got through it, but it's amazing how difficult some of that stuff is.
To add on to that point, in the beginning, all we have written are 8 notes, and one day we sat down and we figured out what each vocalist was singing, and we tried to accent what their articulations were for that specifically thing.
That's so true. A lot of listening, because our parts rarely have dynamics on them. They rarely have accents or anything. So, yeah.
Thank you.
You want to announce this?
This is a more recent one again. It's called We Are Young.
You want me to tell you? No, it's not. It's my first album. Oh. Surprise.
Clearly. I haven't listened to this.
This is on that record deal they got. Okay. Thank you.
Aha, by Emergency.
And it's our last one?
All the cool guys were playing in jazz band. So flutes don't go there, so I moved over to saxophone. The other reason too is my sister played saxophone and there can't be more than one, I mean flute, there can't be more than one flute player in the house. It doesn't work. So saxophone is much better, much more fun for me.
Me? My parents, I play saxophone because I knew it was either between saxophone or trumpet, but then when I was younger, I was like, oh, that looked harder. Maybe I want something harder, a challenge, and yeah, it became this. More buttons, rather than three. So that was my reason back in fifth grade. I was choosing an instrument, so.
I like saxophone better than clarinet.
There is an opening in a concert band for the Barry sax player, and the previous Barry sax player was a flute player, so I was like, I could probably do it. And then I was like, oh, I think now I'm a jazz band.
So my parents had like an idea of what they wanted me to play in fourth grade. Which is very, my mom's right there. And I have to say, so Mother's Day's on Sunday, right? But also on Wednesday, it was her birthday.
Happy birthday!
Happy birthday! Happy birthday! Happy birthday! Happy birthday! Happy
birthday!
Happy birthday! Happy birthday! Happy birthday!
Happy birthday!
Happy
birthday! Happy birthday! Happy birthday! Saxophone, so soprano, alto, and I think tenor, but I play tenor.
Oh, now I know that. He was always
telling me he
doesn't
play. I played in jazz band the whole time.
Oh, I just.
A hard recorder. Barry sax, which I like, and then bass sax, which I. We play that in the sax choir. And then for musicals, clarinet and flute, I'm pretty bad at oboe. And here at Redwood, T.O. here at T.O., Mr. Martone gave me the opportunity to play recorder in jazz band. don't laugh, it was a fantastic solo. That's a little thing.
I play Barry. I played bass sax for one quarter, and then they took me off it. Because I'm like the only girl in choir besides like a couple new people this quarter, and so like all the guy Barrys were like next to me, and I was like really tiny with a big saxophone. So it was really heavy, and I played flute. I played a little bit of bass clarinet. I'm picking up more and more alto, never tenor.
Piano's
a must for all music majors.
I have a question for you. I'm sorry to interrupt, but when you're performing, there's a lot of movement up there, and I have to watch how I say this, because the other day we were rehearsing, and I was telling the flutes in the front row and some other people in the room, and said, you have to move when you play. You have to move, so it helps the phrase along. And it's very odd for them to do that. So can you talk about how you progress from no movement playing to some movement playing in order for the musicality to come out?
I think with this group, it starts from when we breathe together, so we can enter together. It helps us with feeling our subdivision for our entrances and things. I yell at my choir all the time because I look at them and they're like the most sterile things, most of them, because they're like stuck to their stand. And then they have standitis. And their sound doesn't project well. So I try to get them to move, because when you move and you feel phrasing and stuff, you play better. Your sound is much better. Aside from memorizing, that's another story. So Teresa has always moved a lot. We all had to get used to Teresa moving. Albert doesn't quite move as much. Kingsley every once in a while gets his knees going.
What?
And he's like 5 foot and then 6 foot and then 5 foot and 6 foot, so I have to tell him not to do that. But you do have to move. It helps with rhythm, phrasing, and projecting.
I think think also adds to when you play with others, people see that you're really enjoying playing with them as well, and they can get into it more as with you.
Yeah.
And also, audience members, remember, they're watching you, so trying to make it a little bit more fun for them to see that you're having fun.
They don't necessarily hear the music the way we hear it, so they need a visual too, and it helps. That's, you know, you go back to the old rock and roll days. That's why those guys move like that.
Part of it is, though, too, if you don't know music, you're not going to move when you play music.
Right.
So part of it is to make sure that you're understanding what you're playing, you know what you're about to play. And then when you've done that, you're able to look to the director, look around your friends, making sure that you're like in the group, and be able to move in that kind of atmosphere. It's just knowing the music.
Thank you.
In between pieces, feel free to ask questions. Any of us, because we're older than you. And we have room. You can decide, or you have some questions. Experience, that's the right word. Are you happy to answer anything you're wondering about what we're playing, or how we're playing, or anything at all? So I'll start off with what we're playing first off. Or actually, I won't say it, because I think you should know what it is.
And then we'll go to an introduction.
Yes, we'll go to
it. Okay.
Thank you.
I'm Kingsley.
I'm Kingsley.
Playing the piano alto today. I call it my first space engineering major. I'm in my fourth year. I started in fourth grade, so this is my going on 14th year, or 13th year right now, playing.
I'm Teresa. I'm a music industry studies major. I'm a fourth year as well as Kingsley. I played flute in fifth grade, and then I switched to barry sax in eighth grade.
I'm Nick. I'm a music education major. It's my third year at Cal Poly, and I started playing sax in the seventh grade.
Hi, my name is Albert. I'm a third year mechanical engineering student at Cal Poly. This is my 12th year playing. Yeah, 12th year playing. And playing out to okay.
Hi, I'm their instructor. My name is Lori Huff. And this is my 30th year at Cal Poly. So you can imagine how long I've been playing. Something like 50 years. I started as a flute player in fifth grade in the band program. Decided in eighth grade to switch to saxophone because, yeah, these guys know the story. Mostly guys played in jazz band, so I thought it was a good ratio for me, 1 in 21 people. So, yeah, plus saxophone's cool. So I went to that. And I think that's it. And the reason I'm playing tenor is because we're still waiting for a super good tenor player. Not that Nick is not a good tenor player, but he's a good barry player. So, and that's why I play tenor with him.
So the next piece we're going to play is called Funk Funk. It's a short
street song. It's really short. It comes in a collection of about 10 different street songs that you can go out and bust with. And it's designed for just about any instrumentation with saxophones.
You grab this piece from a group over on the other side of the pond. And then you've got a couple pieces from.
And it's going to feature solos by Kingsley and solo by Teresa.
Improvised
solos.
Thank you.
Friday, I know it's Friday. You have to think a little bit harder on Fridays.
Why are you the only one who's a major besides music?
Oh, no.
Well, Albert, also, no, I'm music major.
Oh, okay.
I'm not important, don't worry.
We still love it.
We put the engineers on the outside to hold the music, the majors in.
There's actually a lot of non-majors at the music department at our school, because it's mostly an engineering school. So you'll find that in most of the ensembles, half or more are non-majors.
My dad was in school.
See you next week.
No, that promises.
Well, since when did you start improvising? Because last time I saw you, you didn't like improvising.
Well, I still don't like it. I learned from Janine, to be perfectly honest. He hasn't. But you get to the point either where you love it because you're good at it, or you kind of tolerate it because you're still learning. But, Teresa's great. She makes me feel funny. So don't work up to that.
Oh,
is the alto that I have right now her alto?
The
alto that I
have?
Yeah. Oh, okay. Good choice.
So the next piece we're going to do is a study in contrast by Sonny Asico. It has two movements, so don't clap.
I'm trying to give you an idea of where what the quartets were doing in the 60s and 70s. They were doing stuff like this, not things like the street song or Family Guy theme.
It's Kingsley leaving here. He's played too long today.
My Albert should play, so I'm getting care of him.
Wow, you can get Albert over there.
Yeah.
Darn it.
Another question.
Is that a soprano sax? Or is it?
Yes.
Yes.
Oh, no.
Well,
it's this year for this group. Yeah.
It's always morphing because we have different members here and there. But most, I think, two or three of three of us have been playing together
for long
for since my freshman year.
Yeah.
Our freshman year. So some of us have been together for 4 years. So Teresa and I and Lori.
Yeah.
We've been together for 4 years, and then Albert is in for 3 years, and Nick's quite new. So we gel pretty well because of that.
So as a freshman in a new college, knowing no one, was being able to play a musical instrument an awesome way to integrate into the community?
Yeah.
That's all.
This is a question designed for the non-music majors. Is it hard, like, being, like, a player but also being in another major at the same time?
Yes.
Time-wise.
Yes.
They have to find extra hours to practice because they're studying so much in the other major.
You get good at time management. Spend less time on YouTube.
No, wait, I need to spend my life
somewhere. I know, don't worry.
I said we would
go. We all know that.
Thank you. Okay, so next piece, this flag, is the Pink Panther.
Ooh.
Teresa's going to be leading in the snap section.
We need you guys to help.
So she won't
I can't, she'll get you to start. You can't snap
okay.
through the air. It's really good.
I'm like a crush.
Thank you.
next piece of?
No, we didn't. Okay, so, so this quarter, we like to always like have some sort of theme for our performances, our concerts. So this quarter, we're actually going to do at college all pentatonic songs from the sax quartet. We're going to be covering, you know, Scott, Mitch, Albie, you know, everybody in the group, because we have
five
people.
That's the reason that Nick, that's why we have five today, because we were going to do it with five people.
What's that instrument?
Which instrument?
It's a box.
It actually has a name, it's called a cajon. And he is our version, we couldn't find anybody that could beatbox, it was a saxophone player. So, and Nick can do the cajon. So he is our beatboxer. Teresa's representing the bass singer in cantatonics. And then the three of us are, let's see, we have Mitch over here, Kristen, and then I guess I'm Scott. And all the arrangements we got these arrangements off of MuseScore. So they're all free arrangements. But the majority of them weren't written for saxophones. We had to kind of fudge them around and change them and transpose them. So a lot of them are vocal ones. Question?
Are there groups that are not like just like only one instrument? Are there like brass quintets or something like that?
There's tons of stuff on MuseScore.
Not on MuseScore, but like as like groups, like
We have a brass ensemble at Cal Poly, and there's a trombone quartet, small string group.
Big groups like wind ensemble, contrabass, jazz band.
Right, and then we have a sax choir that has, we're going to have 16 saxophones.
So we're going to play perfume. I hope so.
Yeah.
Nobody wants to know about the saxophones or reeds or anything?
What's different from a silver saxophone than a microphone?
Oh, I get this one?
Okay.
There's thoughts on this. It used to be that the silver saxes were brighter, supposedly, and the jazz players were using them because they were brighter. Come to find out, we went to the Eastman factory, and they have a little display where they have pieces of soprano with all the different finishes, and they played those for us. The dullest metals that they had with lacquer were the silver and the nickel. And then from there, the warmest sounds were the unfinished. They were the warmest and the most consistent. Then you got the gold lacquer next. So that's the whole thought behind it. The other one is there's some that are copper bodied. I think Kingsley's got a copper bodied soprano. And these are also considered warm, like the unfinished ones. So that's the difference. And it's personal preference. Because when you think about it, especially if you're a saxophone player, your sax isn't really your sound. Your sound is your embouchure, your mouthpiece, your reed, and your ligature. And when that all is cohesive, you can play just about anything to get a good sound.
How would you, being in a sax quintet for all these years, say that playing in a five-piece sax section without the rest of the jazz band is different? Because really, that's what a jazz band saxophone section is.
Right. Well, even when you're in a wind ensemble, you're in a sax quartet, because there's four saxophones. And I've always told these guys that if we can get our quartet within that wind ensemble together, we can control the whole ensemble. And it works. And the same thing with the jazz band. You do have all those sections in there. And they should be able to be pulled out one by one and make music. And saxophone players, we always think we're better than the trombones behind the scenes. Usually the berry players want to be in a sax quartet or a quintet because they get to play with the saxophones. Right. A lot of times in the jazz band, they're not the trombones.
So to add on to the silver thing, my teacher, and I believe the silver lacquer, actually, it's kind of temperature dependent. On like, it'll actually play good on like on one day and then play not so good on another.
It also depends on how much brass is underneath it. That's a big thing. So if you buy something that's really thin brass and it's got silver, it just doesn't do that. Yeah. All right. We'll play another one.
So what's the largest saxophone you can get?
That you can buy and afford?
No, I mean like one of the world's biggest. Isn't it like 26 feet tall?
That's the one that's outside the factory in Paris, and it's not really playable.
Oh, okay.
It looks good, though. It looks really good. Contrabass, there are contrabass around. Nuclear Wales has one. And the National Saxophone Choir has one. It's actually up on a pedestal and sits there, and they kind of wheel it around. The person stands on the box and plays it. It's not very movable. The affordable one, the biggest, is probably a bass sax for most people. They'll start new at about $10,000. So, and there, you can play them. It doesn't take three lungs and you know, another person's body for air.
Saxophone is like it has brass on it, but like would it be considered a brass instrument or a woodwind?
No, it's a woodwind because the vibration is created somewhere on the body of the instrument. All your brass players in here will tell you that their lips make the vibration happen. That's what makes a brass instrument. So, realistically, if you go home and you pull that paper towel roll center off and you buzz into it, realistically, that's a brass instrument.
Okay.
whereas this clarinet, oboe depend on their reed for vibration, flute, recorder depend on that back edge of the embouchure plate for their vibration. So that's what separates them. Yet my 100 class, which I teach, is always confused. They'd like to write down that one are all made out of brass and one are all made out of wood. So. Yes, sir.
How long do you keep your saxophones for before you like buy another one?
It depends on whether you like it or not, you know, and what you're looking for. A lot of times as you get better, you're looking for a different sound, a different feel. And that's mainly it. I get a lot of people that have me come play their instruments and see how I like them. So.
Yeah, that first year it was like, ooh. Why don't we play alto? We'll do two altos and a tenor and a baritone. Okay, we're going to play another piece for you because these guys are starting to get antsy up here. And then we'll come back to more questions. But we're going to do Misbehaving by Pentatonics. They're audio.
Thank you.
quick question while you're changing charts?
Sure.
Hey, Kingsley.
Yes, Dave?
Where'd you go to middle school?
Oh, Redwood.
And then hey, Redwood band, how many of you knew that? Sometimes we forget what you know and you don't. So I expect all of you, when you're playing in college, to come back with your ensembles and play in 10 years.
Okay, this is probably one of the first pieces that we brought to the quartet from Mishkor, which was quite, I don't know if you were on board with it.
I was.
You were on board with it, thank you. But it was quite a fun piece, and I was surprised that you knew what kind of class it was. But, do you think your professors are just,
We list the classical music in opera.
Exactly. they're all 100 years old, but they're not.
Yes, we are.
So this was the first piece that we brought.
Go ahead. When you're done, just
one question. Oh, not you. You're not 100 years old. So this was the first piece of
when I taught Kingsley, I had hair just like him. He did this to me.
Anyway, so the piece is called "Is It That Pump My Leg?" Metatonics.
I think that's a four.
Thank you.
Family Guy theme, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's why you didn't announce it, because everybody knows it. Okay, so let me introduce everybody to you. Almost everybody knows Kingsley, so Kingsley's with us today. Play the soprano sax. Fourth year at Cal Poly. He's an aerospace engineering major. And he's in several groups in the department. He's in wind ensemble, sax quartet, sax choir. And, well, let's see. I know you've been playing for 13 years. I learned that today. So, that's about it, right? Oh, yeah, and he's directing the pep band. He started doing that this year. I think he's going to continue. They haven't killed him yet. So he's going to continue with that next year. And he's gotten through all the administrative stuff, so that's good. Okay, and then to his right is Teresa. Yeah, well, I do the theater periodically. Okay. And Teresa is a music industry study major at Cal Poly. She's in the production side of it.
Business
side of it. Yeah, she's going to be producing this. No. So, and she's been there for 4 years. And been playing for a long time.
Jazz band, solo ensemble.
Wind ensemble, sax quartet, sax choir, a little bit. All right, next to her is Nick. Raise your hand. Hi, Nick. Nick is playing Barry sax and box, which is cajon. It's a nice little acoustical rhythm instrument for us to use. So Nick's in his third year at Cal Poly. He's a music education major there. And he's played in soul ensemble and jazz combo, no? That was Teresa. Okay. Wind ensemble, I know he's been in there. And some other smaller ensembles in the department. And then next to me right here is Albert. He's our alto player. And Albert is a mechanical engineering major in his third year at Cal Poly. And then I'm their instructor, Lori Huff. I've been at Cal Poly for 30 years. And I'm trying to stick around at least one more year after this. So. Yeah. So the next thing we're going to do for you is a piece that Teresa brought in. Teresa's into the jazz. So. But she brought this piece in called Blue Bossa, and we all played it when, aren't bosses in four normally? And it's actually in three, but it kind of works, so we're going to do that for you now.
Thank you.
We'll take a few minutes to switch over here. Anybody have any questions? Thought of anything you want to ask these guys?
Do you know if they have a soprano sax in the concert band at TO? Did they? Yeah. All right.
They own a soprano.
I mean, like, are you able to play it? Yeah.
Yes. If you're like lead also, the group.
That's cool.
Ronan actually plays soprano in the Wendell song.
Okay, we're going to go over to traditional quartet thing here. Maybe Nick could actually stand up. He forgets he gets to stand up when he plays. So we're going to play the Pink Panther for you. And we need you guys to help out with finger snapping. And Kingsley and Teresa and Albert are going to get you started. And then Teresa's going to take over for the rest of the song. And the finger pinch. Okay. Is it correct?
Thank you.
Groups, the sax choir and the sax quartet, we meet at night after 8. So, it's either that or it's outside, which doesn't always work out well. Okay, we get our music from just about anywhere that we can get music. Free is always better, but not always available to us. So, Kingsley brought in to me one day. Actually, he said, have you ever heard this piece by the National Saxophone Choir? Their octet doing it, and it was entitled Witch Hunt. And I went, well, no, but I'll go and look. So I went on there, and it opened up a whole new set of parts and things for me to purchase, of course. But they have a publication site, and we went on, we bought the octet first, and said, well, this is cool. Let's see what the quartet's like. So we're going to do Witch Hunt for you right now.
Thank you.
standard is which one?
No.
No. It's not the same.
Not close.
So we're going to start. Every quarter we like to have a theme for our concert, right, for the play writing music. This quarter, for our sax quartet, we're all going to play pentatonics music at our concert, which makes sense because we have 5 people. So we already have the three melodic singers and the bass and the beatboxer.
Well, just not right now.
Right. Not right now, but at some point. But this is the beginning of our pentatonics parts that we play for the concert that we play for you. So this first one we play is Halloween.
Yes, you good?
Yeah.
Thank you. So this piece we're going to play is from the
first
album. It's called We Are Young.
Thank you.